All right, Tommy.
Mm-hmm.
Again, congratulations. I heard a little bit about your business and what you guys are kind of got going on here. And
this is my clone, Adam, by the way, just so you know.
Adam, nice to meet you. Adam.
I'm
Miller.
I know him, but thanks, man.
Yeah.
Wait, yo.
You what? What was that?
Don't worry. Just, you know, continue.
You said I'm an owner.
Okay. Are you co-owner or like?
We're both owners.
We're both owners. He's just taking the piss trying to get, you know.
Well, no, co-ownership. Co-ownership would be two owners of the same equal split, just so you know.
It's very important to distinguish, listen, though, how you can be on. Recognized.
Anyway, continue.
Like, are you also owner or are you like?
Yeah, I'm also an owner. Yes, I am an owner of the company.
Owner, but also owner. Is that
yes,
how
that's
it goes?
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Sure. Or like, owner, this man's creasing. Owner too?
Yeah, I'll take owner too. Just not co owner, please.
Oh, you don't like owner?
I'm going to change his role to also owner, man. Come on. Yeah, or owner too. Fuck it, man.
I'll take owner too, bro. Give me owner too.
Okay, owner too.
It's like owner and then owner, I guess.
It may be owner, well, sometimes.
I'm sure you guys will. Yeah, I'm sure you guys will be working that out. I'm sure.
Hi.
I don't see what could possibly go wrong.
This guy loves it, bro. He gets enjoyment out of, you know, he gets enjoyment out of this shit. So, you know, I let him have his fun.
Well, I so obviously got reached out to by Eve and was told that the storefront has been set up, and that also there will be other storefronts in this area, mm-hmm. you know, being set up. So yeah, we're gonna work with you guys. So we at the factory, we work with the storefronts to get them the customized products, you know, blueprints for the customized products that they'll be using at the storefronts.
Mm-hmm.
We work with the businesses to make sure that their specialization gets set up. Now, that said, you guys are kind of a unique one because you guys are delving into a field that hasn't been brought up. So we're actually building a category just in light of you guys and your business. It's going to be called prospecting. So okay. We wanted to get a bit more insight to your business and kind of how it's going to work and how it might work in conjunction with other businesses. So let me ask you the first question. Okay. I have no clue how gold panning works, you know, or anything like that. So I'm trying to do a bit of homework. To learn,
you know what they say, the best
that.
Research is hands-on research, brother. Hands we got pans restocked. You know what I'm saying? If you want to go, you know, purchase a pan
and
go
right now.
Yeah, of course I'm a businessman. You know what I'm saying?
All right.
This owner too goes crazy. You see him? Look.
Hold I up. See what you're
always
owner,
working.
Listen, exactly. Owner too. Exactly. Listen. We just got some chairs that we can sit on. I say we sit on them chairs and utilize the facilities around us. Over there.
Let's do it.
Here, take my card if you want decorating.
Yeah, we'll sit. I love the chairs.
What side are you getting, owner one?
This side.
I'll get this side on as owner two.
I like to get a view of everything.
Thank God.
Yeah, I like seeing the back of my head.
Okay, so let's talk about Gold Rush, right?
Yeah,
so
I'm busy.
Gold Rush itself, when it comes to prospecting gold panning, right? Where do you guys come in? What's your part in the whole?
So currently the process is you would come to us and you will buy a tray or a pan, and they come in three sizes, small, medium, and large. And with those pans, you will go and search the different streams, rivers, waters of Los Santos. And you know, you place that pan into the water, give it a little shake. You tend to find some interesting products, you know, things that either been like chucked into waters or been lost into the water in waters. But at the same time, you find some sediment which contains some gold. Now you'll find gold dust and gold nuggets. So with those gold dust and nuggets, the aim will be that we'll be buying those off of people and then smelt into gold bars.
Let me ask you this. Is it pretty standard? Like, can I go gold panning anywhere in any body of water, or does it have to be like a stream? How would I go and say, find like maybe where there might be gold, you know, like how would I know?
So you'll find gold across all the streams and rivers and waters of this city. Obviously we'd ideally encourage you to look for streams and rivers, but obviously the nature of this, how the city works, you know, sometimes you'll find stuff in swimming pools, but you know, I'd actually push you away from that.
Yeah, do not do that.
I saw a guy, the reason I bring this up, I saw a guy, it looked like he's been hit with gold fever, okay? He was splashing around in a water fountain. Oh. And he was talking about how, like, there must be watches and other things in here. I need to find them. He was rambling like a madman. So, sounds like your business is already a hit, to be honest.
Oh, my God.
Okay, so you said gold dust. You said the gold nuggets mm-hmm. as well, right?
Yeah, yep.
And in terms of the people that can sell them, can they sell them anywhere, or is it like... Is it more for you guys? Like, how does that work?
What, the dust and nuggets?
Yeah.
As it stands, we are currently exclusively buying the dust and the nuggets.
Oh, okay. So.
And also exclusively selling the trays and the pans. Is that
pasta? Yes. Okay. Question on that then. So, we have some guidelines that we work with the specialization, right? We built up some guidelines where all the products in the city are categorized they're cataloged into categories. That way, stores will specialize and you won't have like jacks of all trades and stuff like it was happening a while ago. We are recently getting everybody enrolled before like the enforcement that starts. So that's why I mentioned building up a category for you guys, right? Like around your shop and what you guys are doing. Something else that we do though is one of the rules or one of the guidelines in these set of guidelines is especially when it comes to third-party products, you can't sell products at your storefront that are produced by somebody else without their permission. That's just a standard, right? Mm-hmm. Like that's just a given. It's a standard. It's there. So regarding your pans, we have a category that is called the restricted category where businesses can officially express that they would not like their products that they produce sold at any other storefront. Or at storefronts. So,
yeah,
is that something you guys would like to do?
Yeah, that would be the case for us. Yeah. So.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Jazz. Also, by the way, this is Jazz Ryder. She's a representative for the factory.
Yeah, y'all.
So, Jazz, can you make a note of that so we can we'll add them into the restricted. And you said they're small, medium, and large, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
You go take a peek. Go give her over there. He'll show you.
Pans or the trays as well.
So that is the same thing. Pans, trays. Yeah. People just call different things.
That's the other thing I was going to ask. Do they need anything else? Like, because I know, for example, there's like metal detecting, right? Where you like go around to find like little areas and stuff. Do you need anything like that?
Currently have the ability to have a probe that you can put in the water to kind of search the water for levels of gold. But currently only staff are using that.
Ah, okay.
So that may be something that we'd add to the storefront in the future potentially. But right now I see the future of it being that only the staff are using that.
Sure. Okay. Then if you want, is that something that's still kind of, let's say, hush-hush in among you guys?
Yeah.
If it's just staff? Okay. So then, we won't mention it then, but when you guys, if you guys are ready to maybe come more, go more public with it, I guess if you guys want to give me a heads up so that I'll add it into that as well, so that it's listed on there as restricted as well.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
it'd probably be worth adding it as restricted regardless, right?
What's that?
If you just add it as restricted from the offset, I feel like it would be ideal because it saves us time. Because ultimately, it's going to be restricted regardless.
Okay. So we'll say we'll add gold probe for it.
Yes, it's called a probe for gold.
Probe for gold. Got it.
Yeah.
Yeah, we don't want to be probing gold.
Wait, why not?
Fuck knows.
You don't want to be known for probing?
Yeah, no, basically. No. I think that's what he was saying.
I'll make sure to note that down.
Yeah. Note that down too for their storefront. They don't want to be known for probing.
Great.
Yep.
Brilliant.
Great. Okay. Then let me ask you this then. Okay, when it comes to gold, right? So gold is produced by a gold penny.
Mm-hmm.
If other people wanted to work with gold, the gold dust and the gold nuggets, let's say, like at their storefronts, let's say somebody specializes in, I don't know, like jewelry and valuables, I think is the category.
Yep.
Where they could do like gold bars, I think is they could work with. We're still trying to figure exactly about that, but for gold nuggets and stuff to be there, in case they wanted to sell them there. What are you guys' thoughts on that? I do want to get your feedback.
Currently, no, because we'll probably be expanding Gold Rush into those territories more, especially like with jewelry and stuff, so we can provide assistance to other companies in the city like Jewel Dragon. So we'll be able to work with the gold, not only to smelt gold bars, but also to maybe like try and work out how to make jewelry parts out of that gold as well.
Okay, so then what you're saying is you... I'm trying to figure out how that would work then, because the dust and the nuggets are a result of this. Okay, is gold panning a public thing? Like, how is that seen? Do you guys know? Have you guys been informed?
What do you mean by is it public thing?
I mean, anybody can get a hands on it, right?
Is it like, yeah, that's what I'm asking.
Yeah, so anyone can currently come to us or this storefront now in order to buy a gold pan. It's the only way you'll be able to get them.
Okay, it's the only, okay. So, okay. All right. Okay, anything else you guys would like me to keep in mind about that? Like gold panning and kind of like anything else that you guys know that you get from it?
You get materials, you get like phones, lockpicks, stuff like that. A lot of that stuff gets sold at Pornhub.
Oh. Jewelry relics.
Yeah, jewelry.
So similar to kind of like metal detecting.
Similar for sure.
Yeah, but on crack.
There's a few trinkets and stuff. Okay. Sounds good.
Yeah, so you would get rings, necklaces, obviously, that can be taken to Jewel Dragon, and relics to go to BLC.
Alright.
Alright, okay, we'll make a note of that.
We still research what else we can find, so that's what we've planned.
No one else will be buying the dust or nuggets, right? So that'll probably be restricted to us.
Yeah.
Gotcha, alright. So then what I'll do is, so the original plan, kind of seeing, like, from my original like first looks into this, it was going to be to have it available in prospecting and in valuables, but we'll just do it for prospecting. We'll just keep it there. And then so then that kind of just designates that your store can, we'll work with those, both the pens and the gold dust, and then anything else that comes up for you guys.
Sure.
All right.
So is that anything as a result of basically prospecting in general, right? Essentially.
Sorry, what? Yes. Now, obviously, like stuff like lockpicks, places can already, other stores can already like work with those and stuff. Of course, they specialize in it and whatnot. So, but that that kind of sorts itself out, to be honest. It's, with Jewel Dragon and the gallery and all that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I guess next thing is the other locations here.
Yep.
So, how do you guys currently have like? In mind how many places are opening up? I know I've gotten some and I've talked to a couple of people, but do you have like an overall number that you guys are looking at? So
I'm pretty sure we'll be filling them all out over time.
Yeah,
what do you have now?
So we have this one, which is obviously now open and good to go, decorated. We have Ved Services two doors down to my right, so your left.
Yep.
Clock and Bell is aiming to be over at the Wigwam restaurant. So that's finally happening, hopefully. I just know there's a bit of a pause on that right now. We have another company that specializes in lighters and that kind of goods, the one right there.
I think they're getting that storefront tomorrow, by the way, like the lighters one.
Okay. Have someone has a request in for the final one, I believe, or has a business in motion for the final one.
Winston wants like a coffee shop for
the one next to the
one, I believe.
Yeah, so I think there's like one that's not fulfilled or has plans to be fulfilled currently, but it will get fulfilled very quickly.
Okay.
The aim is to basically make it like a hub of all the companies that we kind of have under our umbrella.
That's the plan. Yeah.
Which is already starting from this company alone, so.
Yeah. Sounds good. Okay, beautiful. All right. Now, I don't think you guys... now, you tell me if I'm wrong, but I don't know if you guys are going to need anything from us in regards to like, blueprints. Do you guys plan to work with any other products or anything like that? Do you know?
That honestly all depends on what's to come down the line, right?
Yeah, as it currently stands, we know, but maybe if we develop.
Maybe some other stuff. Okay, so I'll tell you. So the factory. So like I said, we work in some storefronts, right? And what we do with some of these storefronts is, you know how there's products that the storefronts can produce. When they produce them, they're generic versions. So they're just, you know, you've seen them, the standard vest and the standard coffee and this and that.
Mm-hmm.
We meet with these businesses once, you know, based on that, they come up with schematics and ideas for these products. So they create other products based on this, on those bases.
On those blueprints,
We put together blueprints. So it's similar to the older Willy system, but it has like some improvements to it. Now, you know, so there's a variety of stuff. And based on their specialization, they can come up with the blueprints and create products around that. Also, something that we can do is we have these other types of products, which are like, if you remember some of the merch products, right, that like some of the record labels have, but and some of the others,
mm-hmm.
And we have a version that can of factory products is what they're called. They have two states, so they have beginning state and then a resulting state.
Why does he look like an old man today?
What they do?
Always looks like an old man.
Shut up! This is an old timey salesman look. All right.
You look like shit.
You're always
so polite.
Yeah, he's a judge.
They love each other.
All right, so here's how I explain it to people. There might be a business that has a statue. When they first get the statue, it's all dirty and grungy looking. You use it, and then it results in clean. It's a clean statue ready for, you know, auction or sale. There are some that come in wrapped up. You use it. Unwrapped, ready to go. You know, it's very good for merchandise. It's very good for like some people use it for patches. Some people have used it for like gifts or promotions and things.
Mm-hmm.
It's got quite a bit going on with it, you know. It's basically only limited by your creativity, really. Some people have done, there's like cards that you can flip face up. There are the core of it is, it has a beginning state. You can use it. We can even specify how long it takes the person to use it. And then it has a resulting state. So people have definitely come up with a lot of things around it. So what I'm going to do is, as the businesses around this Morningwood hub is what I've been told it's called, right?
Mm-hmm.
Get set up.
Yep.
We're going to be reaching out to them, getting them their official specialization set up. Also, kind of give them the rundown as to factory blueprints, products, all that kind of stuff. And so once we get set up, we'll take care of them. We keep that relationship ongoing. So I wanted just to make you guys aware of that. That's what we'll be doing.
Ah, perfect.
Any questions?
I don't think so, no.
Oh, sounds good for me.
Pretty straightforward. Okay. Yeah, we're already going to have you guys noted down, and we'll have you guys down under prospecting. So you guys should be good to go.
What if we expand into selling exclusive gold items, like limited edition?
Because
I know I've had some requests based on this.
All right, give me an example.
I know Miguel from Hydra wanted a golden cock ring. That's an example.
Oh,
right. Yep.
Huh.
Not the weirdest thing that's come through our requests.
But... Would you guys want to make them with the factory, or would you guys? Or is that
No. That's just something Yeah.
You know, maybe we'll get a lot of requests of these rich people who want to like cover some items they have in gold. You know.
Yeah. Okay.
Just seeing if that was possible or feasible. You know, like if we have the means.
Wait, sorry. Say that one more time. I didn't hear.
I'm saying that's possible. I guess, right? You know, like you have, like you said, you have the blueprints down. What if I want to put together a golden lockpick? I don't know, a golden. I'm just trying to think of other quick examples of things you've said.
This is a future capability that we're working on to be able to, take products from the city and give them that spruced up look.
Mm. You
know? So yeah, that's something that's in the works right now. In the product
to do that. We'd need the gold dust that we get, and we mix that with paint thinner. So is there any way we can get like paint thinner?
There's shops that work with that.
Plenty of hardware stores around town.
All right,
gonna be your best bet. Yeah.
All right, no worries.
So
this guy. Yeah,
so if you guys are looking to, if you guys expand the business, I guess the main thing you got to notice is that You will probably have to resubmit your proposal to kind of take into consideration the new the things that you're expanding into if you plan to use Gold Rush for it. And then based on that, then you reach out to me and I'll make a note of it, you know, and we'll update that. That way when PD and, you know, the task force from the mayor's office are going around enforcing this stuff, they'll know that
you're having trouble peeking him?
That's what your capabilities are.
Maybe try leaving and coming back in.
All right.
I can see it fine.
Yeah. All right, beautiful. Let me give you guys my number here real quick.
Does it end in 3361 or is it ending? No, it ends in 8692.
Yeah.
That's so weird. Go.
That's me, John Miller, the fact.
John Miller spelled the number way?
Which one's you? Are you 8692?
Correct.
Yeah, it's him.
Okay, how much? Here, I'm gonna send you guys a...
Sir, how much did I buy it from you directly?
Can you guys send me a quick text? I'm gonna reply to you guys with a copy of the guidelines as well, just so you guys have it with you.
Yeah, I'll go with you.
To look at whenever a moment.
And text you.
We'll get the guidelines updated with the new prospecting stuff and make sure it's restricted so you don't see any random shop just suddenly start dishing out gold nuggets and some of the other things, right?
Perfect.
Yeah, just one. Thank you.
Nice. Already taken to the owner too, huh?
About how long do they last?
Yep, that's me.
Let me guess. He said, Adamababa. Owner to Gold Rush.
So just to clarify, I cannot mix the gold dust with paint in order to, like, you know, make like the golden color effects and stuff, right?
Not that I know of.
As it currently stands,
because I heard that, you know, you could get paint thinner from storefronts. Is that something that, you know, how does that work?
Yes. So there's some storefronts that have been specialized as some of these like hardware shops and stuff, and they can. For example, there's Hard On Tools, there's a Home Depot, Harmony Hardware, there's Nailed It down in Vespucci. So yeah, there's a few of them that are like carry that specialization, so they can sell stuff that like is a hardware store related, including the paint thinner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That wouldn't be something that happens here then.
Not with your current specialization. No.
Okay, all right, no worries.
Yeah, so I sent you guys those. So feel free to, you know, if you have any questions, you know, call me anytime, text me, or if you guys want to, some people link up via email because it's easier. Feel free to do that too. Send it to me. We'll get linked up, and we'll, you know, I'll take care of it.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, love that.
So prospecting be like a whole new specification.
You guys are pretty much there's
actual pioneers.
You guys are exactly, yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, what can I say?
Yeah.
So one of days work, you know?
Let me know if you guys notice anything else. If you guys ever see anybody trying to resell pans or anything like that, feel free to reach out to me. You guys will also, after this Friday, you guys can reach out to like the authorities as well. They can, you know, follow up on that. They'll be part of the enforcement. But if you want to reach out to me, I can reach out to them, let them know. They should know already. That's what these guidelines are for, so that we're all on the same page. You know, everything is out there in the light as to what standards people are being held to. We're all on the same page.
All lovely, right. Jubbly.
Thank Sounds good.
Yeah, thank you guys. Appreciate you guys. And I'm sure I'll be seeing more of you guys around this new hub.
Hopefully.
Of course, man. Like I said, if you do want that hands-on experience, feel free to buy a pan, man. Feel free.
Yeah.
Before stock runs out, you know?
Before stock runs out, hey. People be loving this shit, you know what I'm saying?
They flying up the shelves?
Yeah, you could say that.
Boom.
Yeah.
What do you think of the storefront?
I love the look, and I love how the creativity with getting the doors here.
Yeah.
Mm. You know, this is done, like, within 24 hours.
Jeez. Yeah. It's crazy. Jesus. There's some people that do this stuff that are, like,
LV,
insane.
LV.
Mm. Lana Valentine.
Lana, okay.
Yeah, spread the name, let people know.
She did good work.
So you ever talk to anyone who needs their storefront designed? You know, recommend Lana Valentine to them.
Gotcha. Yeah, we're actually going to build up a...
And then maybe I'll put a few dust in your pockets. No, I'm saying
we're gonna build up a general catalog because people are always looking for designers and, like, you know, interior designers as well. So that is something that we want to work on, but right now we're taking care of the process and specialization first, you know.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, but I appreciate you guys. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. I didn't mean to go out. Thank you. Kind of open that door a bit too preemptively, not gonna lie.
Yeah, I'll buy it off you. Come to the spot and I got
see what our cause.